Welcome to Metal Injection Spotlight. Over the next few weeks, I'll be on a headbanger's journey to explore where metal culture lives and breathes around the globe. Join me as we visit all the best metal hangouts and shine a spotlight on those who keep the culture alive. I'm here in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, known for its hipster crowd, high rent, and cheap parties. But only steps away from the first stop in Brooklyn is the legendary Duff's Bar that has been a home for metalheads since 1999. Although it's moved a few times over the years, Duff's remains to be a staple of New York City metal culture and a great place to party. What's up, headbangers? I'm here at the world-famous Duff's Bar with the owner, Jimmy Duff himself. As the OG metal bar of New York City, what's the origin story here? How did this all come about in the first place?
I'd say about 1999 was the first location that we opened up in Hell's Kitchen. And we've had to move twice, actually, so this is actually the third location. Well, I was looking for a business opportunity, and my brother knew someone who was looking for a business partner, actually. And being a headbanger, metalhead, whatever you want to call it, I just decided to make a bar that I liked. I mean, it's pretty simple.
Was there ever really, like, a hardship having a metal bar in New York City?
Finding a landlord that wants to, you know, let you open shop, you know, you say, well, what's your business? Well, it's kind of a rock bar, you try and tell them, and then they do their homework. It's, you know, devil worshiping metalheads, maniacs that don't want, you know, they don't generally don't want you anything to do with you. So
this is kind of known as like the after party spot for a lot of metal shows, and you've had your, you know, great share of guests come through here and party. What would you say some of the highlights that you've experienced while having this bar?
Having Pantera come down to the bar was awesome. Doing shots with Dimebag, that was amazing. I mean, I could have closed after that probably and retired. I think that would have been enough. One that you wouldn't particularly think would happen was when the place was being built out, I brought Watain here. We came here around 11 o'clock one night just to show him the place, say, hey, you know, this is the new spot. And we ended up staying here until about 11 o'clock in the morning, playing AC/DC DVDs and drinking, you know, doing shots and drinking everything else. So that was pretty fun. They're just rock and roll dudes like anybody else. You know, they're into the same music that, you know, you and I grew up on, everything else. So
I've obviously seen, you know, people like Slayer, Pantera, and even Jimmy Fallon here.
Jimmy Fallon, yeah.
What's up with
that? Well, the old place, the original place was in Hell's Kitchen, and we used to do after parties for Saturday Night Live. So the whole cast would come down, guests or whatever. And we get pretty crazy. So, you know, I became friendly with Jimmy over the years. And, you know, each bar that I've moved to, he comes down, you know, once or twice a year to visit. But he's a rock and roller, absolutely. Jimmy Fallon, yeah, metal, everything.
And what's your favorite part about owning a bar like this?
Well, you have to pay for drinks. That's number one. number two, being your own boss. And, you know, it's not work to me. So, I mean, anytime you can find a way to make a living, you know, doing something you really love to do. I mean, I never take it for granted, you know. Every day I'm happy to be here. You know, I can be here working 12, 15 hours. The time just goes by like this, you know, because I'm working for myself. And I, like I said, I enjoy the work, you know.
Tell us about the hearse.
The hearse, well, basically it's a covered pickup truck, you know. The best maintained vehicles on the planet are what? Hearses, you know.
Right.
Can't have a fucking funeral and have the thing breaking down, so. And they're just fucking cool, man. I mean, I always wanted a hearse, and so that's part of the beauty of having your own business. It's just like, there's no rules. So, you know, one of the first things I did was I went out and I bought a fucking hearse. So I'm on like my third one right now.
And finally, what could people expect walking through those doors here at Duff's?
Loud music, heavy music, cheap drinks, good times, you know, no nonsense, no bullshit, no attitude. You know, that's it, man. I mean, it's all about having a good time. That's number one. I mean, you got to come here. You're going to walk out. You know, people are going to be happy. That's my prime directive. I'm always here to make sure that's how it goes down. You know what I mean?